today we are going to take you around some activities and we hope to stay tuned while we take you around with some interview with the prestigious people that will be arriving today, and we hope to stay tuned. Just stay tuned. Stick to our channel. We love you. President, can you tell us what you are doing here? Why everybody is gathering this place?
Good afternoon, Nigerians. Good afternoon, students of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. Actually, today marks the commissioning of one of the most prestigious projects that is being carried out by the Federal Government of Nigeria under the distinguished leadership of His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari, and being attracted by His Excellency the Deputy Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, His Excellency Senator Ofiomo Agege. And today is the commissioning of this millennial project, as it were.
Okay, that's good. So, Mr. President, can you tell us the capacity and the power of this project and what it can take?
This project is 1.35 megawatts. As it stands now, it's a project that has been able to power the university off-grid, the supply from the NEPA, BDC to say, and other alternative sources. But as it stands now, this project is one of its best that we've ever seen in the university terrain. Special thanks to His Excellency once again, the Deputy Senate President of the 9th Senate.
So we want to know about the neighborhood community. Would they benefit from this project or is it just for the school alone?
I just finished an interview with the general manager of the company. She said that this is the first phase of the project approved by His Excellency, the President Muhammadu Buhari. Eventually, she said that with time, the project will extend to communities. You can check for yourself the Edo State's project that is ongoing. It's powering a community there as we speak, the same 1.35 megawatts solar grid.
Okay, thank you very much for your information. Okay.
May interest you to note that a lecturer in this university have developed what you know as a multimeter. A multimeter to read electric consumption in houses. 1 meter can save 20 flats. Unlike a situation where you go to a flat of a series of flats and each flat has its own meter. The product that was developed in this university can serve that. 1 meter is a multimeter system. In the oil and gas industry, research innovations, surveillance, artificial intelligence, depletion has been a common product we turn out. Recently, a lecturer here produced ceiling board from plastic waste. That is Dr. Yemi, recently. So, I welcome you to this University of Innovation, scientific breakthrough in engineering and science. Secondly, I want to also welcome you to this project commissioning. The commissioning of the 1.35 megawatt hydropower electricity. Sir, thank you very much for this initiation. The very day this project was tested, FUPRI was noon at night. Driving through here at that time of the night, you will wonder, check your time, whether it is 12 noon in the day. Research is very key to us. We have destroyed a lot of scientific equipment because of switch off at the time of 12 hours of the day. Unknown to the person controlling the generators that the research is on in chemistry lab. And by the time, by the 4 o'clock when the water to close, they switch off the generators. And that process take the equipment and the experiment. Sir, with this energizing project, FUPRI is going to be more relevant to the development of Nigeria. We are here to celebrate. The joy we have here knows no bound. But sir, I want to also come to you like Oliver Twist. I will continue to ask. Driving through the university premises, you will see some projects coming up. Recently, the federal government announced a $3 billion grant to FUPRI for infrastructure development. Kudos to the chief, to the deputy senate president. With $3 billion, sir, we are going to have massive infrastructure development. And by the time those projects come on board and they are connected to power, this will not be enough. We are asking for more, sir, to be my professor. Thank you. Having said that, and welcome you to the university, I want to also now say that the commissioning of this project can be earlier than the next 1 minute. You are welcome. Thank you.
Thank you very much. The fight is just breaking
up. Open your mouth for his enemies.
Ladies and gentlemen,
representative that the Ugele will do for that country has ever sent for this project. And then, of course, my brother, another of my brother, representing Okbe Satele Uri Efila Constituency, and another group, Efe. My friend, the Vice Chancellor of Federal University of Human Resources, Professor Rima Kofure, I must acknowledge our royal father. Of whom we are ably represented here. Please permit me to stand up at this protocol. On the 17th of October 2017, after three national assemblies, three presidents, and a decade of operating without a specific legal framework, the Federal University of Petroleum Resources and FUPRI received a breath of real life. What is Excellency? President Muhammadu Buhari, GCFR, graciously assented to the enabling law, establishing it as a strategic national asset for the development of specialized human resources for our nation's energy sector. Our people will forever remain grateful to Mr. President for his leadership vision and the patriotic spirit with which you wholly supported my humble sponsorship of the bill establishing FUPRI and its constant support for our commitment to represent our people productively in the Senate. The last time I came here was when the Senate Committee on Tertiary Education and Tech Fund visited FUPRI on a parliamentary oversight duty for first-hand knowledge on its academic and development affairs. During that engagement, I talked briefly about the earnest desire of Mr. President and our people for this university to attain a solid footing so that it can seamlessly achieve its clear objectives. Today, as I stand here with a great sense of optimism, knowing that the vision of this Citadel of Excellence is unfolding, thanks to Mr. President's continued support and his agenda to transform our nation's education sector for the better. My compatriots, today is another big day for FUPRI, as it comes under the federal government's Energizing Education Program, EEP, which is designed to provide sustainable and clean energy to 37 federal universities and 7 university teaching hospitals across the country under the auspices of the Rural Electrification Agency. It is an honor indeed to be part of this historic event. With the commissioning of this hybrid solar power plant today, solar energy will be delivered sustainably to FUPRI. I have informed that at 1.35 megawatts capacity, this hybrid plant will produce enough electricity to power the entire FUPRI community and cater for the energy needs of its over 6,000 human population. This project is also projected to create over 100 jobs and significantly boost FUPRI's local economy. The stable electricity will also naturally impact positively on the security of this environment, especially at night. Ladies and gentlemen, this 1.35 megawatt solar hybrid power plant is part of the President's larger vision to diversify our economy, diversify our energy mix, stimulate our national economy, create more robust avenues for national income, fight endemic poverty, and positively march forward on the path of sustainable economic development. Today's event is a significant opportunity because of what solar energy solution represents. First, it is part of the present global energy paradigm shift, and we cannot afford to be left behind. Secondly, it is a veritable solution to our endemic power problem. Thirdly, it provides hope for creating a cleaner, pollution-free environment. And finally, this is what happens when you have to use IT, you know. Finally, it is happening in FUPRI, an institution with a mandate that includes the development of clean energies. This itself represents a positive challenge for members of this institution to be leaders in clean energy research and development. Another dimension of solar energy solution that provides a good challenge to FUPRI academic community is its environmental friendliness. FUPRI is situated in an environment where pollution resulting from the exploitation of fossil energy is endemic. To this extent, it is smart to creatively take on the challenge because, as they say, necessity is the mother of invention. Solar energy technologies are relatively young and fast evolving. There's room for new strides. This is your time to make real impact. Let the world hear about your exploits in this regard. It is equally important to emphasize that globally, nations are moving away from conventional energy sources to renewable ones because of the limitless opportunities. We can be a part of this innovation. Let us take a cue from similar initiatives in even some third world countries that are making significant strides in the field of renewable energy. India, for example, pioneered biogas technology by way of anaerobic digestion, 80 plants. Today, Kenya is reportedly close to attaining 100% mark for renewable energy for all of its electricity needs. Nigeria can also make giant strides in innovative solar energy solutions. We have abundant sunshine. We have solar scientists and researchers in great number. Some are here in Hope. Also, the federal government has several incentives, including tariff waivers, tax reliefs, specialized loans, and intervention funds for solar energy development. Our nation's renewable energy master plan encourages profitable participation in solar energy research and development. There are huge gains in solar energy, and I only encourage Fukui to take the lead. As I move to end these remarks, let me quickly advise against poor maintenance, as already alluded to by the Deputy Chairman of the House Committee on Power. So I quickly advise against poor maintenance of this hybrid plant. Fukui must stand out as first among other institutions in ensuring that the system operates optimally at all times. This will guarantee the sustainability of this 24-hour all-round electricity supply initiative. Finally, let me thank my brother and friend, the Honourable Minister of Power, Engineer Sani Mamon, represented here by my brother, Prince J.D. Aba, for his admirable commitment to this program for the federal government. We are here today because of his result-oriented leadership in the power sector. I must also express my sincere gratitude to the management and staff of the ROEA, led by my brother and friend. And also to MECTA, West Africa, and Nigeria Energy.
See, people, you would have gone inside and start from there now. Okay, no, this is also go there. Where is this?
It's not there. Formally unveiled this 1.35 megawatt solar hybrid power plant under the guiding education program BEP of rural and technology area.
Hey! for your turnaround, you will receive back.
Commissioner of this project can be earlier than the next 4 minutes. You are welcome. Thank you.
Thank you very much. The fight
for
this breaking
up. Open one up for his enemies.
Ladies and gentlemen, I have the singular honor of inviting for his remark, his royal remarks, Dr. Emmanuel Akemejawan Sideso Abe I, the Ovi of Uwe Efurun, Delta State, ably represented by Dr. Chief Samuel Jimo Eshenake JP. Please, let's welcome him as he comes.
His Excellency, the Deputy Senate President of the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, I beg to stand on already established protocols. Before I will read my remark, I want to convey the apology of His Royal Majesty Dr. Emmanuel Akemejiwan Sideso, I, JP, OON, Obi of Uye Kingdom, that he would have loved to be here personally because of his passion for this great university. But as you know, as a royal father, he's engaged in some other serious national engagement. So please accept the apology on his behalf. But despite that, he's ably represented by four high chiefs from the Uyo Kingdom. I welcome you to Federal University of Petroleum Resources in Uyo Kingdom and wish you a happy stay for this period of commissioning and pray for Johnny Mercy when you are going back to your various destinations. I read the speech of His Royal Majesty. I'm sincerely pleased to be here today for the commissioning of the 1.35 megawatt solar power project here at the Federal University of Petroleum Resources, Efurun. Delta State is very privileged to be the host of this milestone achievement. As a state, we embrace new development and transformational changes such as the Energizing Education Program, aimed at improving the lives of our people. With renewable energy, our indigenous can enjoy the benefit of clean, safe, and reliable electricity. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, the entire staff and students of this institution are indeed grateful to be recipients of this federal government of Nigeria's project under the Energizing Education Program. And I'm certain that the state government is also happy to host today's August visitors. The advantage of providing access to stable and clean sources of electricity impacts the entire nation, as we can now nurture competent and technically trained graduates who will contribute to various sectors of our economy. To our great students, you can now reap all the benefits of this project, and this should be seen in your exceptional academic results, especially now that the federal government has addressed one of the key challenges. Over the year, I have heard stories and experienced firsthand the challenges students experience studying and learning without electricity. This is now a thing of the past for our university, thanks to the Energizing Education Program. I must commend the vision, strong commitment, and collaborative efforts of Federal Government of Nigeria, the Ministry of Power, the Ministry of Environment, the Rural Electrification Agency, the private sector contractor, and the Federal University of Petroleum Resources on the realization of this outstanding project. Once again, on behalf of the Traditional Council of Uye and the state government, thank you for gracing this occasion. A hearty congratulations to us all. Thank you.
Let's put our hands together once again for the Royal Father. The Vice Chancellor gave me a challenge, and I think I'll take it up. I hope there's a powerful course on that Urhobo language here. But it's getting easier as we're going along. But then again, forgive me if I'm pronouncing the name wrong. It's not me, it's the microphone. Distinguished Deputy Senate President, Your Excellency, ladies and gentlemen, please, we need to know what is this project about. What is it about? And to tell us about the FUPRE Solar Hybrid Energizing Education Project is Evangelos Kamaris, who, however, is represented by Engineer Chukwuka Isechie, the Deputy Business Development Officer. Can he please join us at the podium? Please, let's welcome him as he comes along.
His Excellency, the Deputy Senate President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, His Excellency, the Honorable Minister of State for Power, the Chairman, House Committee on Power, His Royal Majesty, the Ovie of Uwe Kingdom, members of the House of Representatives, the Managing Director of the Rural Electrification Agency, the Vice Chancellor, Federal University of Petroleum Resources, Executive Directors of the Rural Electrification Agency, the Head of the Project Management Unit, the Nigerian Electrification Project, gentlemen of the press, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, good afternoon. First of all, we would like to sincerely thank the Federal Republic of Nigeria for granting us the opportunity to be part of the Energizing Education Project. For us at METCA, this is a remarkable initiative that gives us the opportunity to mark our contribution towards providing sustainable energy access in line with the mission and vision of the federal government of Nigeria, implemented through the Rural Electrification Agency. Ladies and gentlemen, METCA is the Sustainable Engineering Solutions Business Unit of Mytilineos SA, a leading Greek industrial company, also active in metallurgy, power and gas, renewables, and storage developments. With a consolidated turnover of approximately $2.3 billion, Mytilineos strives for constant business excellence, balancing economic growth and sustainable development. METCA, the Sustainable Engineering Solutions Unit of Mytilineos, undertakes the construction of large-scale turnkey power plant projects from design and procurement to construction and commissioning. These power plants include thermal power generation, large-scale photovoltaic, and hybrid power technologies. Our project portfolio is over 15 gigawatts with successful projects across Europe, Middle East, and Africa. In Africa, METCA has projects in Algeria, Ghana, Tunisia, Uganda, and Nigeria. Nigeria is indeed a very strategic market to our company. We enjoy the energy, the enthusiasm, and the drive of its leaders. We also believe in the government's ability to deliver uninterrupted power supply to the Nigerian people, which is why METCA was quick to set up an office in Lagos, currently one of the largest subsidiaries of Mytilineos overseas. On February 2018, we were awarded the EPC contract to deliver hybrid solar plants to four Nigerian universities: Bayero University, Nnamdi Azikiwe University, University of Petroleum Resources Efurum, and Usman Danfodio University. Through this project, METCA has employed over 100 talented. Thank you for all your support. To the REA team, especially the Managing Director, Engineer Ahmed Saliijo, thank you for believing in us and giving us this opportunity. You have been fantastic, and we have enjoyed the synergy working alongside you and your brilliant team. To the Honorable Minister of Power and the Honorable Minister of State for Power, you continue to demonstrate your commitment to not only this project, but to the power sector as a whole. Thank you, Your Excellency. To His Excellency, the Vice President of Nigeria, Professor Yemi Osinbajo, we greatly admire and appreciate your steadfast commitment to the achievement of this project. Our sincere gratitude to you and President Muhammadu Buhari for this opportunity. METCA greatly believes in this country and the vision of his leadership in the power sector, championed by His Excellency President Muhammadu Buhari. We are here to stay and will continue to support this government in the development of the Nigerian electricity market until Nigeria has a stable and reliable power supply. To the students of this prestigious university, you are in the 21st century, which is rapidly shifting from the traditional industrial economy to a more digital economy. You must remember that with this project, your days of darkness are gone. It is now time to rise up and be the shining light of the world, which you are. Ladies and gentlemen, Oshe, Dalu, Nagode, thank you very much.
though.
Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, the next item on the agenda is invitation to the podium, the Managing Director, Chief Executive Officer of the Rural Electrification Agency, Engineer Ahmed Salihijo Ahmed, to tell us about the Energizing Education Program, EEP, of the Rural Electrification Agency.
Your Excellency, the Deputy Senate President of the Senate of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, the Honorable Minister of State for Power, the Chairman of the House of the Chairman House Committee on Power, ably represented here by his Deputy Chairman, our High Chiefs, ladies and gentlemen, allow me to stand on existing protocols. Good afternoon, everybody. Let me start by welcoming you all, and you have found time to be here with us today at the University of Federal University of Petroleum Resources, FUPRE, to commissioning yet another Federal University project, which is the 1.35 solar hybrid power project under the phase one of the Energizing Education Program. The completion of this project, in addition to many joys that we have witnessed since the inception of this program, I'm very happy and proud to say that this is the fifth university that we are commissioning. We started off in Ebonyi State, went off to Kano, Benue State, Bauchi State, and now we're in Delta. So I'm very happy that this is happening under my administration. The very aim of the Energizing Education Program is to continue to provide clean, reliable, and sustainable electricity to 37 federal universities and 7 associated teaching hospitals. I'm happy to update that we have already started the phase two of this program, funded by the World Bank, and we are also going to start the phase three shortly after that. So this is very good that we are making progress on the Energizing Education Program, which continues to target rehabilitating existing distribution infrastructure, provided designated street lights for illumination and safety, as the VC has mentioned earlier, as well as provision of world-class renewable energy workshop and training centers in each of these beneficiary institutions. To my left, you see that there are 20 female students who were selected from this university, and they have been the beneficiaries of the STEM program that we have, and we're very happy today that we're going to graduate them into this particular university, and they know that they have been part of the process of the taking up the power plant, and they've been working closely with our EPC contractors. So we're very happy about this because they are going to form part of the sustainability plan that we have for this particular project. So as some of you may know, the REA has a huge mandate of electrifying 2.5 million households nationwide, and also in line with the EPRG of the Federal Government of Nigeria, I'm happy today to say that the education sector clearly is one of our major priorities. So of course, I would like to use this medium to thank and appreciate the Ministry of Power, today here with the Honorable Minister of State for Power, for the effort in moving this off-grid sector in the right direction, aimed at providing electricity infrastructure in rural communities to improve quality of life. And also to thank the Federal Ministry of Environment. At the last commissioning, I shared a very short personal story where a few years ago, as far back as 2016, I was part of the team that worked for the then Honorable Minister of Environment, where we raised the Green Bonds Program. And the Green Bonds Program is a part of the funding that the federal government used to actually construct this university. I had no idea that when I was in that team, today I will be the MD of REA to come and be part of the commissioning of this program. So it's very personal to me that at least I've seen the hard work that I've done then coming into life today in 2021. So ladies and gentlemen, so we'll continue with 37 universities across the country. And of course, we can't do that without the cooperation and the management of the university, able here today by the VC who has given us a lot of cooperation to get this plan to where it is today. So I want to thank him a lot for his enthusiasm. And as he mentioned, as Oliver Twist, you know, so we'll continue to see how we can support this very good institution. And I want to use this opportunity to also thank the EPC contractors who spoke earlier, Medca West Africa, for this successful delivery of this program. And the entire REA team, I'm very proud of your efforts, and I look forward to having more and more of these sort of projects during my tenure. And of course, I would like to round up by thanking His Excellency, the President, President Muhammadu Buhari, and His Excellency, the Vice President, for even giving me an opportunity to lead such a young organization to deliver on rural electrification projects across the country. Thank you very much, and I'm very happy to be here today.
Please, let's put our hands together once again for the Managing Director, REA. The next item is remarks by the Permanent Secretary, Federal Ministry of Education, which will be done by his representative, Mrs. S.N. Okuta. Please, let's welcome her.
And power sector. As we commission the 1.35 megawatt solar hybrid power project here at the Federal University of Petroleum Resources FEPU under the Energizing Education Program PSOE. The commissioning of this project signifies a huge step towards providing reliable and affordable power supply to millions of Nigerians in their homes, schools, communities, hospitals, and enterprises across the country. It is noteworthy to reaffirm that the Energizing Education Program.
Thank you very much. The Honorable Minister of State, Power, my brother, my friend, the Honorable Prince J.D. Baba, Chairman, or Deputy Chairman, Committee, House Committee on Power, my brother, the most competent